there it is again. Radio 420AM, W.E.E.D.
W.E.E.D. 420AM, DJ.G9D in the building. My man Alexx.
In the building, says this every week. It's
I do,
like
bro.
Catch
I
phrase.
Say it all the time.
It's like tradition now.
Don't interrupt my in the building, bro. My in the building is top notch. Oh, he knows my in the building because from back in the day, he knows all about being in the building.
Yes.
He knows about
we got
it.
Some
he's
guests
been,
in
he's
the
a radio
studio.
Vet. Also, we're going to have some guests tonight. This is going to be awesome.
Guests
we'll
in the studio.
That.
They'll be on later.
That's right. Our third guest officially.
They're warming up to it.
Absolutely.
Once more beer starts flowing, they'll come out natural.
The beer.
That's how it works.
Beer is flowing already.
Cheers for beers. This week's show is brought to you by cannabinoids and Bud Ice and Bud Light.
Collective program right there. Bud Ice and Bud Light collaboration. Cheers.
They should have made one of them green, so one's like the Jets can and one's like the Giants can.
But they're both from the same brand.
Football season's over, guys. I know you. Everybody misses it, but that promotion ran out a little while ago. Anyway, being this is 420 AM WEED, I want to get into a good story here. So we talked about this a few weeks ago with this fake weed, supposedly. K2 Spice, Mary, Sweet Lucy.
I've actually went out and did an experiment and I've tried some of this.
Okay, well, let me hear your experiment first and then we'll get into the story, the weed story.
This is exactly how it feels. It feels like pot. But you don't feel you don't feel hungry and nothing is funny. It's the weirdest experience.
It has a little bit of that.
It's just a body high. That's it.
Well, it's not a body high really, because a body high is more like if you smoke hash. But that one, it's like it's similar, but it has like an extra like tinge to it where like I don't know if I want to be in that
state.
Have
you been sampling the goods as well?
I haven't. I did it once. I did it like maybe once or twice. But I have, you know, I can tell the difference. I'm very much of a weed connoisseur. I can tell the difference when I smoke the fake shit. And the reason I'm bringing this up is we spoke about it a few weeks ago.
Of course, it tastes much different.
Yeah, and we spoke about it a few weeks ago.
You'd be an idiot not to notice that.
It causes like seizures in people or whatever. There were some cases. But our friend Chuck Schumer, not really our friend, the Senator Chuck Schumer, he proposed a bill. He proposed a bill to try to make this stuff illegal. And guess who is blocking the bill? It's Rand Paul. Ron Paul's son. Yeah, Ron Paul's son is blocking the amendment saying
Wait, his name is Rand Paul?
His name is Rand. Like short. I guess it's short for Randy, but it probably isn't.
There's a lot of creativity in that family.
Well, listen. I think he's named her after Ayn Rand. Atlas Shrugged. So
that's the conspiracy theory on the streets.
I'm pretty sure he's a libertarian. I don't know if Ayn Rand could be considered a libertarian, really. She's just really, like, sad to read. But I guess he named her after her last name. Makes sense. It's kind of like Randy without the Y.
I talked to a libertarian once. They couldn't find the book I was looking for.
All right. Very good. Bada bang right there.
You like that? I stayed up all night writing that.
Yeah, because you knew I was going to bring this up, right? So they're blocking this bill, and I'm actually kind of happy, because this is the stupidity of government. Why don't they just make real weed legal, and then they wouldn't have to worry about fake weed being an issue, because no one would care.
I've seen a headline exactly like that somebody posted on Facebook.
Yeah, it was me, because I'm on top of this shit,
I don't believe it was.
It's so dumb. They're trying to make this. There's a bunch of them. K2, Pandora, Potpourri, Legal Funk, Spice. I've heard of Sweet Jane around here. And they sell them everywhere. And this is like a local story because like Chuck Schumer is obviously a New York senator. And I'm like, this is so dumb. Why doesn't he just propose an amendment to make weed legal? Nobody will be smoking fake weed, so no one will give a shit. They'll stop selling
you
it.
Know what the
Hence,
name?
It's not in the stores anymore.
You want to take a guess at the name of the fake weed I smoked?
Around here is
It was called Dead Man Walking.
Really? Okay. I guess. I never tried that
That's
one.
Not a very enticing name.
No, they should work on that. They should work on the name of that.
That's bad marketing.
I guess that's why I never heard of it. All the other ones have like Pandora, Potpourri, K2, Spice, Sweet Jane, or Sweet Mary, whatever it is. That one's a little too like cryptic for me. I don't want to die. You can't overdose on weed, and that gives people the wrong impression when they call it that. Dead Man Walking. It's a little too over the top. I don't believe in it.
I don't only you would can reconstruct it in your head like that.
I'm just saying, that's why they're not
popular. I didn't think that at all.
Yeah, I know. I'm very analytical, bro. I think this is pretty evident at this point of the show.
Allegedly more analytical than Google search engine.
Yes. Well, ha ha ha. Very funny. That was a very that was a nerd joke if there ever was one.
Yeah.
Analytics, come
on. And if
you
got some nerd jokes, call us up. 347-67-420-AM.
The hotline is operational, which is awesome. I want to get into these guests because they're fucking chomping at the bit. You want to take a quick break? We'll come back, do some guests.
Are you kidding me?
We'll do like a 2-minute break.
We're not even on 5 minutes mark yet. We're not even on the 5-minute mark yet.
Let me just give them a prep.
A prep?
Yeah, so they can get on air. The listeners won't know there's a break. Only we know there's a break.
Of course they will. I'm not cutting any of this out.
All right, fine. Okay, whatever. Let's get into it. You're
all right, fine. We'll be right back.
No prep time. My man, MC.ILLZ is in the building. Say what's up.
Illy in the building.
No, hold on. I got to give him prep time.
A.K.A. MC.ILLZ. Gennady, what's going on? Alexx, what's going
on? What's up, buddy? I'll give you a quick on-air lesson. Mic 40 degrees and don't slide your hand up and down on it because it transfers the sound.
See, now you want prep time. Oh, all of a sudden, no prep time.
That's a weird kind of prep time. I'm not signing up for this.
It was a quick on-air tutorial. That's fine.
All right, he's got MC his name. He can hold the mic. Master of ceremonies, mic controller, whatever. Hold the mic right. You've been doing it for long enough, all right?
I'm holding the mic.
He knows how to rock the mic right.
We're doing all right here.
I think so. So,
how you guys doing tonight? What are we talking about? What's the topic of the day?
Put your cap on sideways.
Well, that's what we're talking about for now, but here we are. We got you on the air, and I'm not very proud to say my longtime MC and longtime DJ combo here, DJ G9D and MC.ILLZ, the legendary. So we should definitely.
DJ G9D.
I go first, yeah, because it's my show. MC.ILLZ and DJ G9D was like at the rap battle when I was doing your intro. This is like on air podcast, the Pod Blast podcast, in fact.
We're getting blasted while we cast it.
Exactly. And there ain't no truth to that. Speaking of that.
Those are some cheesy hooks, I know, but they are
ask
catchy.
Ask your favorite MC who his favorite DJ is. There he goes again.
He's DJing on the bong right now. Hey,
I know
like
who your
that?
Favorite DJ is.
Who's my favorite DJ?
You're looking at him.
So that makes me the favorite MC, doesn't it?
So, it was a good intro, and me and him have been working together for many, many years. And, how about kicking a freestyle? What do you think? No, I said, no, spit a freestyle. Don't just
No, we're going to spit a freestyle later.
No, why? Why? It's good. You're ready, right? Bro, you spit on
DJ G90 is
gotta,
on fire today.
You got to ease him into it.
He is definitely in the building.
He's in it, bro.
He's in the building.
You don't want to start a show and bust the load too quick. Save the freestyle for the end of the show.
What happened is the beer actually came out of my nose.
That was that funny? Comedy stylings, DJ G90.
That's what just happened.
Got you in an uproar.
Can I get a paper towel out of your freezer?
Yes.
This guy keeps his paper towels and his tissues in the freezer.
Oh, come on.
I feel like when he was a baby, he was raised in that freezer. They used to change his diapers in that freezer.
I got some good memories in that freezer. That's my favorite freezer, bro. That's what I keep it in the garage.
He's like, yeah, sir, I keep my chicken cutlets.
Oh, man.
All right,
like,
bro.
I love chicken cutlets.
You got
and his frozen potatoes.
You say potato, I say helicopter.
Potato.
All right, you ready, Ills?
Yeah,
I'm putting you up.
Sure.
I'm going to give you a
you
banger.
Say shrimp, I say lobster.
Banger.
A banger, what's that?
A banger track.
Clue us in.
Big banger.
Wow, you give me a lot of editing work to do later.
Nope, shut up.
Yeah. G just wants to, like, throw some fire on. DJ G9D, MC.ILLZ, 2012. Yeah. We got Alexx in the house, man. It's been a while.
Up?
Wow. Yeah.
It's been a few days. Radio
yeah.
420, exclusive.
1, 2. Yeah.
Turn
Try
my headphones up.
Illy's Ills, more green than Godzilla is. Type of knowledge you wouldn't find browsing Mozilla, kid. Search the whole net in your own head. I flow it, I know it, you know it. So take a slow breath. Fast step warriors like Asterix. My lyrics and Asterix hit the fast stretch and fast whips. Crashed them into the mansion. Got plenty of acres with the lake. I'm flipping the coppers on the stove like bacon. Taking forsaken ships, trips, and they baking gifts. Fat like Buddha's forsaken tits. Fuck it, I'm straight up caking. Flipping glasses to all your bastards. Getting my cash quick. Passing you faster in the ass. Now I'm blasting out the back of the fucking Acura that's chasing you behind you. Fucking blowing up your mind too. I'm fucking exploding. The flow is fucking golden. Cut your throat, leave you bleeding. Throw you to the bottom of the ocean. The flow is atrocious. You know the animal of the game like a rhinoceros. You preposterous. You must be fucked up because I know you can master this. The cocaine coming down your nostrils is fucking going crazy.
All right. Very nice. It's real life, bro. That's real life shit you're spitting. I got some shit.
It's your brain. It's so big it don't fit in your head no more.
When I said spit, I meant spit some rhymes. Don't spit on my garage floor, bro. I mean, did you get that one? From now on, if you're going to be spitting, let's keep it to the rhyme variety. Because I got to mop that shit up later, bro. What do I look like? Exactly. That was pretty good.
That was
very, very nice.
You know, I just... I got before that one happened.
No, it's all good. No, you went for a while. That was like 3 minutes worth of freestyle.
It would have been funny if you said, what do I look like? And then you have a big bundle of keys on your hip. It doesn't have the same flair that way without the keys.
This is a remix. It's DJ Paul V, Lady Tiger versus Justice.
You got to talk into the mic, guy.
Yeah, we're not here to upset you.
No, we're not. We're here to make people happy. This is
important. We don't want to make them mad. That'd be funny though. Then they would be calling you up, and you would be like, "Tell me why you're mad." And then they gotta tell you why they're mad.
You've been saying that to me lately a lot.
That's
why don't you could tell them.
Why you're mad?
You could tell them why you're mad at 347-67-420 AM. Call us up and tell us why you're mad.
Somebody wants
son.
To call us and tell them why you're mad. Just call us up.
And that number again is 347-674-2026. Call us up.
That's why you still have the house phone. That's why, NG, that's the only reason you still have a house phone. Because when you do need to dial a number on your cell phone that has digits, you have to look at your cell phone, dial the number while looking at your house phone. That's why there's still house phones. I'm telling you. Surprisingly, a few cell phones have that, but most don't.
Most
you can't do it on a BlackBerry. Can't do it on a BlackBerry touchpad. No
well,
way.
BlackBerry, because BlackBerry's insane, because it's a whole keyboard, so you can't tell anything.
No, you're not getting out of there.
The numbers you think are the numbers.
It's a MIDI QWERTY.
The numbers for the keyboard.
Yeah.
It's a MIDI QWERTY keyboard.
Yeah, it's really complicated. In
that. That's not really that complicated. You just can't dial numbers, you know, letters on numbers on the BlackBerry keyboard.
Those are the easiest
keyboard.
Numbers That's to whack. Remember. Numbers with
you
words.
You should be able to just put in letters, and it should figure out what that number is.
Basically.
That's stupid. Whoever programmed that should get slapped.
Well, who are you trying to call anyway?
Nobody. I'm just saying, like, soon we'll have,
you're
like,
call 1-800-SLEEPIES?
We're going to have, like, sunglasses with your phone in it already and shit. That's coming out really soon.
Yeah,
Google's coming out with that. That's their new jump off.
No, they're going to have a glasses.
Yeah, glasses with internet, man.
Google. Yeah, it's going to happen. You guys are
going to get a new domain.
You know, that's what I'm trying to get in on.
GoGetInternetGlasses.com.
I'm here actually, you know, representing GoGetGlasses.com today. I got my partner in crime here today, Francis Graham. He'd like to say a few words.
Yeah, say a few words. What's going on?
5 degrees?
We're
closer. All right. A little closer.
Yeah, how much closer you want it, yeah?
Closer.
Closer than that.
That's good. Oh, be careful grabbing the mic so hard. It transfers sound.
Well, I mean, you know, like, we're in a multi-billion-dollar business, and it kind of sucks, actually, currently being one of the small people in the business, but there's so much room to advance, you know, because everybody's walking around with a set of eyes. You know, I can't speak to everybody. I'm sure there's some people with handicaps, but, you know, almost everybody needs some kind of protection or something. And if they don't even need a pair of glasses, they probably need like an eye patch. So, you know, there's just so much things we could do here. You know, and me and Frank, we're here. We're, you know, we got this website that, you know, me and Frank are famous for reconstructing websites. I actually got a good buddy that has been doing a lot of that for me. I'm sure he'll be on the mic a little later on.
Like the Civil War.
But, you know, we change up our website a lot. But
so what kind of deals do you have on eye patches right now?
I'm currently trying to work something out with an eye patch manufacturer.
So what are you saying?
Luxottica
is fucking you real hard right now?
No, actually. You know what? They're actually fucking everybody because they're the guys making all the bucks.
They're like the Clear Channel of glasses.
They make the big bucks.
Everybody pays them. Yeah. They're making money from everybody.
They're like the Clear Channel of the eyeglasses world. You know, in my opinion, eyeglasses, though, like, they're really becoming, it has to be more of a fashion trend now than anything else.
It is a fashion trend, but at the same time, look how many more people have bad vision now.
It's
even the generation we grew up, let alone, let's talk about our parents, we didn't really grow up sitting next to a computer since we were, like, 5-4 years old, did we? Do you know how many kids right now are growing up, like, well, but it was just the beginning.
I grew up on a computer.
But look at kids now. Look at kids now. They're by the computer after, like, 3-4. They're sitting in front of a screen. They're going to have bad eyes. I mean, yeah, LASIK is up, but, you know, LASIK is still a surgery. God forbid it goes something wrong. You can't get it for a certain age. You can't get it with certain kind of prescriptions and won't correct everything. You know, there's just there's a lot, you know, in that topic. So, okay, we're going to get your mother's
glasses. Yeah, please do. What is the show degraded
down? GoGetGlasses.com. There you go, Frank.
All right, we got to take a quick commercial break. We'll be right back right after this. Hurry up. Oh, he choked. He choked. Yes.
Oh, that was powerful. I think I'm ready.
And G90 is back to choking on it.
I'm alright. Nothing about ice won't fix.
Yes.
Send him an invoice.
What doesn't it fix? It's good for like so many problems.
Alright. Today's a very special episode. Stupor Tuesday, as you'd like to call it.
I'm definitely stupor because I haven't slept in like 48 hours.
Yeah, no. Just election tonight, there's like 10 states going. We're going to check out the results of that in a little bit. Right now, one of our favorite segments, 2-Minute News Abuse. You ready?
Yes, I'm ready. If you don't know how 2-Minute News Abuse is played, it's like this. He names a headline from the whatever the most popular news is right now. And even if you don't know the topic, you have to make a funny comment in one or two sentences about it. Okay. That's all we do. We don't go into actual detail about...
I mean, unless it's really good.
Okay, yes, exactly.
Sometimes we get caught off track.
All right, and
that's the whole fun of this game. All right. Frenchman sues Google over views urination photo.
She must have been shocked. I can't believe she reported
man,
that.
Bro. It's a French man, okay.
Shocking. See, this is why I don't really mess with the French.
That's why.
You know, I don't really like the French.
You actually reported that?
I got tricked into drinking that Pinnacle vodka.
Yeah, he's suing Google, a French man, on Thursday in the court last Thursday. Is the Google view from above, you know how you go to Google Earth?
Is he the one in the video?
No, the Google Earth photo, the permanent Google Earth photo, is him pissing in his front yard. In a village in northwest France, this happened. So, literally, when you go to Google Earth and you type in his address, if you go to Google Earth and you zoom in all the way,
so
it's him pissing in his front
honestly,
yard.
Honestly, I think if Google just...
That must have been a wild party.
If Google really just builds him a nice bathroom, like he could avoid pissing in his yard. So they could avoid that whole lawsuit by just installing a nice bathroom.
I don't think Google's in the bathroom business.
Now that motherfucker is a Kodak moment.
I don't think Google's in the bathroom business, but you know what? That's a funny story because I bet if you scour if you scour all of Google Earth, like the tri-state area.
People do that.
One of those photos will have Ilya pissing somewhere. I guarantee it.
You're saying I got caught in the act, right?
I'm guaranteeing that if you looked through like all of the clubs or like bars and lounges you've been in the city, at some point while you were pissing outside, which happens a lot, no offense, but it does, because you have a bladder of a 3-year-old. But
so do I. When I'm drunk, bro, I gotta go, bro.
Yes,
there's
but
no
don't you think that at
it.
Some point there might have been one of those Google cars with the camera on and just driving by,
well,
and taking a picture?
I'll tell you what, though.
It depends on your drinking speed. If you drink really quickly, then yeah, you can't wait.
Yeah. It's a car, drives by, has a camera on the roof, like 4 feet up. That's how Google Earth is built. And they just piece it together. So it's not really satellite? The satellite is the actual map. Like, the map is satellite. The way the pictures are taken, the video, when you zoom in all the way.
It looks like a car that has a smoke alarm held up by scaffolding.
Yeah, exactly. It's a little, like, fucking Prius, but it has, like, this fucking camera sticking out the roof, like, 4 feet up.
What's up with that new Google policy, though?
I don't know much about that. Alexx is our internet expert. Can you comment on it?
What Google policy?
Like, you see how they can basically see us everywhere with Google Earth?
They've been doing that.
I know. I had to say I agree to this new policy about Google when I signed into my Gmail. What's up with that?
Oh, I just click skip.
Wow. Dr. Internet over here.
I'm not here to, you know, say, you know, commenting back on you saying that Google Earth has caught me in the past. Actually, probably pissing in certain areas.
Don't you think so? Somewhere
I'm sure
it's
happened, but you know what? I'm not the French man, but you know, I in no way feel violated, and
you're proud of it.
You know, I'm not gonna do something.
Take pride in your
over Google because at the same time, like you know, what would be the situation? You know, how would it go if you're suing Google? Like, say this French man is suing Google for this case, right? Now, does that mean he can no longer use Google at the time while suing them? Because he really can't have any part with them, right? So
nah,
he can't even search something up
Google.
If he really needs it in an emergency.
He'll use
so
Bing. Cue the laughter.
In a way, it's probably affecting his life somehow right now. He's probably pissed. He's
Google's
like,
definitely going to settle.
He's like, I really want to search this, but damn it, why did I have to sue Google?
He could always ask Jeeves.
Yeah, cue the canned laughter on that one as well. But yeah, no, I'm pretty sure
I'm the king of one-liners.
But what if Jesus and I'm happy with him? Like, come on.
I don't know. He'll be fine. I think what ends up happening here is he's going to settle. Because Google hasn't gotten time for this French nonsense. They're not dealing with this. They're like, yeah, we'll give you like $1,000. Go fuck yourself.
They might edit the photo, probably. I don't know. I don't think it's, like, obscene or anything. I'm pretty sure it's not, like, full frontal. It's probably just, like, like, you can barely see anything happening. It's just him pissing. You know what I mean? Because it's mad grainy anyway. So I don't think it's really a violation. But I'm telling you, I'm sure that Google has...
It really all depends on...
one day, I saw the Google car pass. You know, I might be on Google Earth somewhere, just walking.
Getting back to the guy, it really depends on how big his lawn is. If he has a small lawn, it's going to be a clear-ass picture.
Well, that means the road was rural right French. I'm pretty sure it's a picture of, like, a vineyard or some shit. I mean, I can get more details, but this is 2-minute news abuse, not 12-minute news abuse. So let's get back.
That was a 5-minute news abuse right there.
I know, 12 sounded better there. All right. Dog's feet give Japan scientists pause for thought.
What? Was that a haiku?
Feet of a dog?
Read that headline again.
Swear to God, this is it. Dog's feet give Japan scientists pause for thought. Pause is spelled P-A-W-S. So.
But they discovered something about the dog foot?
How's
that relevant
you tell me,
to
2
anything
news
in my life right now?
It's a pretty funny headline, though.
Well, it's very cryptic, bro. You gotta give us headlines we can really comment.
I can't spell it out for you.
So Japanese scientists are spending time on studying dog feet.
Apparently.
Commenting on a headline like that is like commenting on a song name.
They're just like big-ass calluses, and like they can walk on anything.
Right? I don't think I should spend too much time on that one. There's more important things going on in this world.
Alright, no more news abuse. Escape penguins outracing Tokyo authorities.
That's the one you thought.
Right.
I got you.
So nice. Don't bang on the mics. Stop punching the mics. Hold it steady.
So the penguins did what?
You gotta.
They outraced the Tokyo authorities.
So they're like Tokyo tripped into police.
You gotta talk into the mic, guy.
Yeah, apparently. This guy could be. That's a pretty good plausible explanation.
It could be.
It could be. You can drift on ice, mad easy. So, penguins. All right, next one we got.
Maybe a little too easy.
I don't know, bro. I mean, penguins are pretty quick. They look pretty quick.
Yeah. Oh, I'm talking about drifting on ice. I mean, you're talking about penguins. We're on two different pages here.
How can you not drift on ice?
The communication's breaking down here in the studio.
Yeah, but how would you avoid drifting on ice?
It's the goddamn pot.
How would you avoid drifting on ice? There's only one way to
drive. Why would I
want
to avoid drifting on ice?
Exactly. You would have to
drift on
ice.
That's the only one place you could drift at slow speeds.
You're sliding sideways. On ice, it's much easier to drift on ice than it is on concrete.
Because it's at much slower speeds, it's nicer.
Yeah, exactly. So it makes sense. The penguins are quick. That's why they have better feet. Their feet are like tires.
Illegal drifting. Just blame it on the snow.
All right. Russian election satire takes Putin's manhood.
Yeah, what the fuck is going on with you?
That sounds pretty gay.
That's what it says. Yeah, because he cried, so they're giving him a hard time about it. Because he stole an election and cried about it. It's kind of funny.
Yeah, Russia,
that's all propaganda, man.
You don't think... Dude, he did not, like, win by a landslide. You don't need to cry. What's his name? Like, the Speaker of the House did that. And he's, like, a tool. And, like, no one respected him for it. And we just made fun of him more. I don't need my politicians crying, dude. Like, if you're going to be representing me anywhere, stop crying. What the fuck? I don't cry. I don't even represent myself sometimes.
That's a good point.
What, he was trying to get through to the ladies, the female vote? Yeah, there's more women in Russia than there are men, so maybe he's got... Yeah, there are. He's like, yeah, it's a problem, supposedly.
Yeah, alcoholism is more rampant than men.
That too. The alcoholism kind of doesn't do too well. So, like, there are more... No, right now, though, like, population-wise, it's like almost 60-40 at this point. Yeah.
Yeah.
Russia's got like a lack of men. If you go to Russia, you're guaranteed to get laid, most likely. People are like, there's like actual like women like who have like these like companies that help people help women find husbands and shit. Because it's like mad hard.
That's what he's trying to equate it to.
That and like there's mad way. It's like, you know, parts of the country are sparsely populated.
Definitely part of the problem.
Yeah, it's parts of the country
are
sparsely populated.
That's basically what it is. It's all alcohol. It's the wrath of vodka.
It probably is. I mean, what's happening is that the Asians from, like, the outer regions are coming in and really, like, you know, they're, like, making it their country. Like, if you're not in a major city, it's mostly Asians. It really is. She got some insight over here. MCO's girlfriend. She knows. So, I don't know. It's true. I mean, if you're, like, in a hot business, start a dating, like, service. In Russia, importing, like, men from other countries. Hell, I import myself, dude.
How do you drop ship a Cadillac? I don't know, but I'm sure there's a way. Call UPS to pick it up.
Dropship. You're going to have to take a boat, my friend. Yeah, no, that's what they're saying. Literally, there's an erotic art show, a museum, whatever, of art, erotic art, which it has, like, all these, like, I don't know, I guess, like, pictures and, like sculptures without Putin without his penis.
You can't make this shit up.
No, it's mad funny. I'm trying to get a little more in the article, but yeah, I mean, yeah, there was a lot of protests. The protests that happened in Russia this past year. Some of the pictures, I don't know. It doesn't really go like that deep into it, but it talks about like
a lot deep into it.
No pun intended. So, you know, well, listen, you're right. This is some shit you cannot make up. You can't make this shit up.
Don't fiddle with it like that.
There's actually a picture showing Putin and U.S. President Barack Obama comparing the sizes of their penises. Apparently, this is some insider information that this museum has.
Why have the last two out of three stories you named been about penis?
This is the same story. Yeah. Oh. This is the same exact story. This is a big story. Like, the Russian protests that happened there this past year.
One
bigger...
is way too many.
No, hold on a second, dude. I'm just saying, this is a pretty funny story, dude. This is a funny... Okay. The Putin Erotic Museum, bro? Imagine this shit happened here. It'd be hilarious. This would be huge. It'd be trending all over the world.
Someone started fucking an exhibit?
I don't know, but I'm sure they figure some shit out. They'll figure it out. I don't know. But yeah, no, so this is pretty funny. And the protests that happened in Russia this past year literally were bigger than the protests that happened when the communism started taking over.
Right.
There were more people at these protests than there were during the Red Revolution and shit, like back in the 20s. So this is some major, like a lot of people dislike him. And it's true, because Putin's basically a KGB operative, kind of like Obama's a CIA operative, more or less. So, I mean, I'm breaking that news here, but it's probably true. He came out of nowhere, went to Harvard, he got elected president, he's black, he hasn't gotten shot yet. He's definitely a CIA operative. If you don't think Obama's a CIA operative, you're not following politics. Don't you think so? Who was he before he became senator of Illinois? No one ever heard of him. Putin? Who was he before he became president of Russia? He was a KGB operative, no one ever heard of him. He was randomly picked out of like 60 other generals in the KGB to become president.
Tell him why you're mad,
G. I'm mad because the system doesn't work. And he won supposedly in this landslide election. How can you possibly have so many protesters and so much like voter fraud, like suspicion, and win this election by a
landslide? That's how he won this election.
Yeah, dude, it's nonsense. Maybe he won it. I'm not saying that he lost it, but he definitely wasn't. He wasn't given this much of a mandate because unlike in the United States, in Russia, the more votes the president gets, the more power he has. It doesn't matter if you win by like one vote or a million votes in the U.S. You're still president. Over there, the more people who vote for you, the more power you have, basically, because you get all those other seats. You get to appoint all these officials to the Duma and shit. So there, like, the amount of percentage that you get is way more important. And then
that shit is fucked up because
those people Russia's supposed to be basically like a pretty modern country for the most part. This is happening in all kinds of third world and Arab countries, I understand. But Russia, for the most part, they should really, like, they have the potential to, like, make this happen for real. They can have a real country. Some countries have no hope. Russia, they got some industrious people. I'm Russian, obviously, and a few of my friends are here. And it's definitely a country where, like, if they get their shit together, it would be, like, a top world power again. Easy. They have so much resources, so much land, so many Asians. It's ridiculous. They're just, like, they can really go bonkers if they need to.
Yeah, your mic is off.
My mic?
Yeah. Click the on switch on.
It's probably off the entire episode.
I don't know. Did you see the levels?
Is it on now?
Yeah, it's on.
Everything's
now.
Working. Everything's functional.
Everything's working. All right, now.
Frank. Here you go.
Yeah. So
it was off.
Getting blasted while we casted.
Was it on?
It was on at some point.
Okay.
And then
some
point.
So any other
I just
crazy
restarted
stories
this beat
that
anyways.
That might happen at a tanning salon.
Yeah, women walking out naked.
Naked.
Like, yeah.
That's pretty cool. Who's the most tanned person you ever seen in there?
Snooki.
Like crazy.
Imagine Snooki coming to the
This is your publicity right there. Any kind. That's definitely
pay,
publicity.
You're made.
You have to pay 11,000.
You're made man someone. Then.
Yeah. No, it's not worth it.
Now she's having a baby. Like, what's up with that?
Sorry. Just kidnap the baby. It's a bigger story.
That's it. Ransom.
Well, yeah, let's go and do this. Who wants to kidnap Snooki's baby? We will take better care of it than Snooki. Anybody want to do this? I mean, it... See, I'm telling you, this is a good idea.
The honor.
This is going to be bigger than the Lindbergh baby. Except for she has no talent. She can't fly a plane.
Yo, that's happening. When's the Mayan calendar? When? 21st?
Of December.
Yeah, that's when she's supposedly having a baby. You see that in the news?
Oh my God. Yeah. Snooki bringing
up
yeah,
like the
apocalypse?
Joke on the internet right now.
It could happen. I wouldn't put it past her.
Yeah,
well, no, I'm telling you, but this baby's definitely gonna get is gonna get kidnapped.
Everybody just straight hates on her. Who gives a shit?
Like, exactly.
Fuck it.
I know.
She's doing whatever the fuck she wants.
But I had a capital idea, bro. This is the first time anyone's even thought of this. I'm breaking fucking ground, bro. Kidnapping Snooki's baby. Come on. That's a groundbreaking idea. No one's thought of this yet. Nobody. I mean, this is like.
Think about Snooki's job for the last few years, bro. She's getting paid to get wasted. And just hang out.
Just hanging all day.
That's it.
Own a show house.
Just hundreds of thousands of dollars just hanging out and getting drunk and shit, making myself a fucking asshole. I would do that in a heartbeat.
And that gives me the right to criticize her all I want. Because she makes this money, then I don't feel bad. And no one should. That's why she's a public figure. Hence, I can rag on her all I want. Regardless of how much money she's going to waste in the next 3 years and go bankrupt, I can really still rag on her because she's a public figure. And that's the beauty of America. Bro, for now, until Romney takes over, and the Mormon re-education camps begin.
The Mormon state of fear.
It's coming, bro.
As you once
don't
so
vote,
eloquently
don't vote
put
Romney,
it.
People, please. Or else we'll all be wearing magic underwear.
Perhaps.
Yes. Anyway.
As long as you don't have troll face on.
I think we should take a quick break and come back with another freestyle by MC.ILLZ. I think it's a great idea.
It's been 2.5 minutes since we fixed the mic, so we're going to break.
Bro, that was right back. Nothing was broken. Visit beautiful Virginia.
My evening is brunched by Bud Light.
Their primary actually was Brolic.
Does Gingrich win anything, though?
Yes. Speaking of Gingrich, thank you, Frankie. Georgia, of course, Gingrich's home state. He won Georgia. And because I guess like all the fat guys in Georgia were like, hey, if he can become a politician, so can I. So I think Gingrich got it with the fat boat, which
hey,
is like 60% of Georgia.
I have loot in my swamp.
so that's like that. Although Georgia's a proud state, I don't understand why they would vote for this like nonsense candidate. But you know, Georgia got Ludacris, and they got T.I. Where's Ludacris and T.I. stepping up for Georgia? Stepping up for Georgia. How are you gonna let Newt Gingrich win your state, Georgia? So tip of my hat to Virginia, wag of the finger or whatever you want to call it. Georgia, you're dumb.
Thumbs down.
You're the dumbest state of this primary. Of the 10 states, you are the dumbest. And you were running with Idaho and North Dakota. Somehow you managed to be the dumbest state out of all those. That's a feat right there.
That's a good observation.
Yeah. Well, North Dakota has like 100,000 people living in it.
These results piss me off.
Okay, so let's go through the rest of them. So we got Virginia, the smart state, which didn't even let Gingrich and Santorum on the ballot, which is amazing.
They didn't get any Santorum on the ballot.
Georgia noobed out, somehow had Gingrich win. I know Gingrich is from there, but come on. You don't have to be proud of everybody who comes from your state. You know what I mean?
True.
It's not necessary. You know, like, just because somebody comes from somewhere, you don't have to vote for him. You should really, like, use your head more. Yeah, dude. I don't think they won tonight. I'll be honest with you. But
the
I will
Knicks
check
update.
It. The Knicks update.
You got the Linsanity fever.
Yeah, the Linsanity has slowed down a little bit, but let's see what it says. Ooh, they made it close, but they couldn't pull it off. 95-85.
Now turned into Lynn consistency.
Yeah, no
Steve
one,
Novak.
I really got squashed.
The Steve Novak score line was 13 points, 4 3-pointers, 3 rebounds, 1 block. So that's pretty good. Anthony, I don't know. Steve Novak's on my fantasy team for this one
Blocking
game.
Blocking sucks.
How much points did Carmelo Anthony have against the Dallas Mavericks? On Stupid Tuesday, Mr. Anthony was able to manage 6 points and 8 rebounds. Nice.
Oh, no.
Wow. One assist, 2 turnovers, and that's it. And a personal foul.
Yeah.
8 rebounds, though. Where was that? Where does 8 rebounds come into play? Shot 2 for 12. Fantastic. MVP, bro. Oh, my God. Whatever. It's all right.
Wow.
I'm not that upset, I guess. We'll survive. Dallas, wow. a tough game. We beat them once. Beating them twice. Couldn't do it on the road. So, you know, we'll come back, see what happens with San Antonio.
Bro, you're talking like as if you were in the game, bro.
We're big hard
like, yeah, we're
fans.
Sorry.
Me and Ilya have gone through a lot of mixed nonsense. Prophet Isaiah. I'll be happy to report to you that, you know, I went to see the Kings-Knicks game a couple weeks back. I told you about that.
With Rich.
Yeah. Yo, so they have this kid on the Kings, whose name is Isaiah Thomas, bro.
Right, they were
you
booing
don't
him,
understand.
Me.
They're booing him like crazy.
Well, you should not walk into Madison Square if
with
that's
that
name. Doesn't he still work for Madison?
No, he works for Florida International University,
wow.
FIU.
Wow.
He's the basketball coach.
Finally got the idea,
yeah.
Right?
Dude,
it's time to go.
Yo, this kid got booed so hard, he's a rookie.
School.
He didn't know what was coming. He's like, well, but that's not my... He's like, it's just my name. It's a coincidence. Like, it's like, funny because like, every time he touched the ball, everybody would boo him, including me. And, like, the kid looked so confused. He's like, oh, you mean the other Isaiah Thomas? No, that's not me. But that's, like, what he was doing on the camera. He was like, no, wrong Isaiah Thomas. He was so confused because he had, like, 2 points. He got so frazzled. You got like 6 turnovers. They got destroyed. The Knicks won by like 24 points. So it was actually a 15-point victory, but they were up by 24 like most of the game. So it's pretty funny how he's named the same as the other Isaiah Thomas, who's like a legend, a Hall of Famer. And because he destroyed so many franchises, like, I bet if that guy, when he plays in Toronto, he probably gets booed too, because Isaiah Thomas kind of fucked up Toronto Raptors as well. So, I mean, I'm sure he gets booed in like a lot of cities, except for maybe Detroit. That's where we actually won some championships, won the Pistons. So.
Sao Paulo, Brazil may be another one.
I don't know if he's going down that far, but we'll see about that. Anyway, so, Ilya, as we were saying earlier, you're back in the mic. MC Illz, my longtime MC, good friend of mine here, and we're going to really do another freestyle, for real this time.
DJ.G9D.
Exactly.
What do you mean we? What I'm
he
not
got?
Doing anything. It's him
no,
doing
no, no,
everything.
It's just him.
We've been freestyling all night. What do you mean? We haven't stopped freestyling.
You ready, though?
Sure, why not?
This is a soul build-up. We'll give you an introduction.
Give you guys a little
MCOs.
Lyrical moment.
By way of St. Petersburg, Russia, hailing from Brooklyn, New York, currently resides in Staten Island. Let me hear what you got.
In the building, baby. Yeah. Drink a 6-pack, fix a flat without using a jack. I use my tool, fool, I never get screwed. As the NASDAQ rises, see the streets through open high eyelids. Bow down to your highness. Millimeter 9, the rhymes is fucking crazy. Arrange your faces with phrases like raises. Fuck it, started rapping in the basement with a bunch of bass heads. I fucking ace this. God gave this, no imitations. Boombox and play this. I stay piffed. I keep taking the game and changing it. So what the fuck you saying? You ain't making any sense. I'm making some dollars, building a couple houses. You're still flipping a couple ounces. Look, this is just the way it was meant. I just put it this way. I wrote the book, but you're still reading between the pages, pointing your finger. But it's okay, cause we still a bunch of haters. Francis Graham fucking building up a fucking monster on the internet.com. Go get glasses. That's where you're gonna be making all your purchases next for your spectacles. And maybe one day we'll even sell some belts. Fuck this, you can't test this. The devil infest us in the chest. Sit. Red creatures with features. They teach us and teach yous like teachers to buy some more shit. I'm a fucking website, so why don't you type it right now? Use your fucking QWERTY keyboard and start fucking putting GOGETGLASSES for you fucking fat ass motherfuckers sitting next to a computer hitting with UV rays through your open window while you're smoking your fucking cigarette. Marlboro's what you getting for $12, that's killing you at the fucking deli. The fucking Iraqi fucking laughing while you're buying a pack and fucking sparking in the parking lot. I'm sparking pot, I'm hot in the fucking block. I fucking flow from the bottom to the top. I pour the bottom from the top to the bottom. Fill the cup from the bottom to the top. I set my jack on a rock. Brock.
All right. Give it up for that right there. Nice.
Yeah, I'm so glad.
MCO's in the house.
I'm so glad we got those people upper stoppers.
You were popping some pieces. That was fire. That's one way. That's my optician right there, people. That's what I expect.
Yeah.
Excellent service. Freestyle ability.
I want somebody to pitch me the sales pitch in rap when I go to this store.
That's that's like
I get a customer like that one.
Dude, you're like the celebrity off pitching to the stars over here.
Sale and shit.
Just like whenever you see a celebrity in the street, you gotta rap to them why you are the optician. You are the optician to be.
That is some hilarious stuff.
That was really
properly
good.
Properly hilarious.
You guys are funny. I'm
really? Not just like mildly hilarious.
A little background on that. MC Illz, my man. That was a sick freestyle. I've heard most of those raps already.
90 now.
I've been with you for a really long time. So
how come Alexx ain't getting into this?
He
retired from the rap game. He's Suge Knight. He's retired in prison. That's basically it. we used to always hit it up. That's how we started. That's how this whole DJ thing came up about. It was started with hip hop, 2 turntables and a microphone. I know I'm dating myself, but it's true. So I mean,
what does dating yourself mean?
It means I'm like making
does
myself.
Does it happen every evening before you go
I'm
to
making
sleep?
Myself older than I am, because 2 turntables and a microphone or could be a reference to the 80s. You know what I mean?
But it probably isn't.
No, it's the early 2000s actually. Is when this all started. But, we've been doing this for a really long time. MC Illz been on SOU several times, some battles he's been in. So, he's a seasoned vet, been doing this for mad years already, and I've been beside him for many years. So, this is what I enjoy. It's my passion. It's my passion right here.
His specialty is huskies and Yorkies and small dog surgeries.
Oh, shit. I'm an animal in the game like a husky. The feds can't bust me.
That's right.
You must be rusty. They've been looking for me for years. Trust me.
Nice. Frankie Graham is another guest.
It'd be funny if they released an official statement saying, no, we didn't.
Tonight's a monumental night. Monumental. Super Tuesday. And we're having a really good time. This is really, the atmosphere in the studio is electric tonight, I gotta say.
Oh, come on. Using these cliche-ass phrases.
It is. I'm
Don't
sorry.
Bring that bullshit over here.
Fuck you, bro. I'm feeling really good.
The atmosphere.
I'm fucking feeling good. I don't care what you think. You can't bring me down, hater.
Well, this hating is pneumatic.
It's not pneumatic. Anyway, Frankie Graham's in the building. I want to take advantage of a guest here, so I don't know. What you got for me?
G in the studio
what
giving physics to a feeling.
What you got to bring to the table? Let me hear something.
Make sure your mic is on.
Make sure the mic is on. Because we got
traffic coming in.
Traffic control, we got you. Step aside. One.
Yeah. All right. Welcome back.
W.E.E.D. 420 AM, DJ.G9D, Alexx. MC Illz, Frankie Graham's. We're chilling.
But where are we?
I can't give out that location. That's a
But we are in a
building. Right. DJ G90 in the building. All right, so Stupor Tuesday, we were talking about it previously. Stupor Tuesday, big election for the primaries, the Republicans, all this nonsense. And Mitt Romney won like 7 out of the 10 states, so whatever, who gives a shit.
Biggest concern right now is that I ashed all over my pants.
That sucks, bro. We don't need to know about that. We can discuss that off air. Actually, no, let's not even discuss that off air. That's just nonsense. So we're going to play a little game. I didn't make this up, so I got to give Mad Magazine some credit. But there's a bunch of sayings.
Come on.
There's a bunch of sayings. You're going to like this. Take it easy. Take it easy. Don't poo-poo the store.
Don't let the liberal media tell you how to think or feel.
I will, bro. I will let them, because it's better than the conservative media. Anyway, who said it? Mitt Romney or Mr. Burns? And anyone can play. So we'll keep track. I'll announce a winner at the end.
All right, prepare to lose.
All right. All right, first one. I've always been... I'm sorry. All right. I've always been a rodent and rabbit hunter. Small varmints, if you will.
Mitt Romney.
Yes. Ding, ding, ding. All right, 1 point for Alexx. All right, next one. Who said it, Mitt Romney or Mr. Burns? Why do I need another penny? I have billions.
Mr. Burns.
All right, we'll call that one a tie. Good job, guys. You guys must have seen that episode.
Yes, many times.
All right, here we go.
That's like every episode.
Exactly. Here's another one.
It does happen as you get older. You've seen the same shit so many times.
Considering the Simpsons have run every storyline in the face of the earth, it's like, it's hard to avoid it. Simpsons did it. Here's another one.
They didn't have a bondage episode.
Then I think they might have. At one point, Homer got freaky.
I don't think so. Right,
maybe just a cartoon I saw online.
Only Family Guy gets away with that kind of comedy.
Nobody
else on Fox
Simpsons
gets away
pushed
with
the
that
envelope.
Shit.
They pushed the envelopes. Anyway, getting back. Here we go. I'm really enjoying the so-called ice cream.
Mr. Burns.
Okay, you got it. Okay, here's another one.
pal.
I keep zoning out on this one.
Pay attention. That's the part of the game shows. It's very important. You got to pay attention. So
who's the other guy? Wait, who's the other guy we're talking about?
Mitt Romney or Mr. Burns from The Simpsons?
All right, we smoke like five bong loads and drink a 40, and then he wants us to pay attention.
Mitt Romney.
Yeah, well,
Mitt Romney?
Brilliant. Yeah.
Who's that?
What do you mean, who's Mitt Romney? What? All right, it's Mitt Romney. Anyway.
He's all right, can we go to the next question? This game's falling apart.
No, it's not falling apart.
Apart at the seams, as they say in the industry.
Okay, shut up. I grew up drinking Verner's and watching ball games at Michigan and
Romney. Romney.
All right, I'll give that one to... Oh, yeah? This anonymous clan of swag-jawed troglodytes has cost me the election.
Mitt Romney.
Mr. Burns.
Yes.
Oh,
I don't think that he would say swag jaw.
But
I mean, he might.
I take no pride in that answer. That was like just like the process of elimination. And it was only two answers.
I know. I'm running for office for Pete's sake. I can't have a legal.
Mitt Romney.
Yes. Okay. Tying it up. A blue collar bar. Let's go swimming.
Mr. Burns.
Yes. Very nice.
That was a tie too.
That was a tie. Nice. All right. I like being able to fire people who provide
Mr.
services
Burns.
To me.
No, Mitt Romney.
Yes. Oh, there's good
one. That was on the Daily Show a few weeks back.
It might have been.
It was.
All right.
Science fact.
I'm not concerned about the very poor.
Trust me, I'm a blacksmith.
Mr. Burns.
No.
I didn't even hear the phrase.
All right, then you missed it.
He's not concerned about the... Okay, Mitt Romney in that case.
No, it's not.
I got it. What do you mean?
All right, here we go.
You can only buzz in once.
This is a good one. This is recent. I have some great friends that are NASCAR team owners.
Mitt Romney.
All right, nice. You guys are on point for that. Let's see if I have any more. Oh, well, this one's really easy. So what should we do tomorrow? Go grousing?
Mr. Your Burns. Girlfriend.
Tied it up. The last question. Very nice.
I gave that one away.
With your girlfriend. It was worth it. The tie was worth it.
Yeah.
You tied in an epic blaze. You went out very nicely. I'll definitely say that.
A bit of glory. I asked on myself again.
It was somewhat glorious. So,
this
since
pot
Ilya.
And beers definitely work.
Since Ilya did such a great job in that Mitt Romney or Mr. Burns, I think he deserves another freestyle opportunity. What do you think, kind sir? Will you bless us with your mic skills? I can't take requests because
bang,
I'm gonna...
Bong, 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 bong.
No. I can't give you bong, 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 bong. We're gonna go the...
About you, bong, bong, bong.
We're gonna go the uncopyrighted method today. I'm sorry, bro. You're gonna have to deal with it. But I think I got some really good shit that you're
no,
gonna...
No, I
enjoy.
Really meant...
Bong, 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 bong. Yeah. I don't know which one that is.
The one right next to you.
Oh, the bong.
Oh,
oh, this is the 420.
What are we talking about?
I thought you were getting into some Borat shit.
Oh,
was
right.
A song like that? Bong, 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 bong.
Bing bong.
Who made that song?
The Bing bong song. Borat.
Borat made that. Bing bong, bitty bitty bing bong. Bing bong. Right? That song. All right, here.
Okay, places.
You got to pack that.
Well, why don't we play that game for now that Alexx wanted to play?
Germany versus Poland.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I know I'm a special guest here.
Try.
You guys all have a lot of AKAs, but what are your guys' host names? Like, I've been wondering.
G90 and Alexx Sounds or Alexx.
Okay, or DJ FM.
Whatever the fuck.
No, that's old. I don't use that anymore.
Don't use that.
My hand.
Don't use that. Alexx Sounds.
I changed my moniker.
Alexx Sounds, DJG90.
It doesn't matter. This will never be heard.
What do you mean? Yeah, well.
Or whatever preceded this.
W.E.E.D. 420 Radio.
That's right. It's the Pot Blast Podcast.
Get
Pot
blasted Blast while we cast it.
That's our motto. So, since we're talking about mottos, I want you to spit something about 420 AM W.E.E.D. right now. Are you ready? This is going to be a familiar track.
Yeah, can you do what you're doing best?
I'm going to.
That's for you then.
It's a familiar track.
I'm going to have to sync up all these beats to his background voice.
It's all right. The magic of the studio. Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it, G tells me.
Yeah. It's a right to be sarcastic while we pod blasting, pop blasting, podcasting. Fuck it. We're getting raspy. We're still packing this bong while being classy. My eyes glassy. You're moving too fast, B. Slow your fucking roll. Roll the fucking bowl. Take a fucking toke. Fucking bowl the circles out of nose, out of my nose. Watching you fake catch choke. Relax, sit back, sip the martini. Don't lip that, the split fat. Pass it to the guy next to you. It's Francis. Francis sitting next to DJ G90 podcasting. Everybody listening, tune in. The best show, 420 AM. We, W-E-E-D. We got Alexx Sounds.
Yo.
Yo, he's on the microphone.
I'm high in my dome.
High to the dome.
We G's coughing, choking out.
And passing, G's smoking, he's laughing.
This is what this evening has degraded down to.
France is selling glasses.
All right, all right, all right.
He's smoking that Snoop Dogg Kush tonight.
That's right. Now, oh, fellas, this is real. Any denial, this is real. This is damn real. So, as you can tell, DJG90 in the building. So, that was cool. You do another one? Let me talk about it. Let me talk to you a little bit.
Talking to the mic guy.
Talking to the mic.
We're still recording.
Let me talk to you a little bit.
Absolutely.
So is an MC. What's your...
Bro, let him holler.
What's your take on the hip-hop game today? It's very different from when we grew up. It's night and day, almost.
That it is.
I wouldn't say
it's changed much.
It has changed a lot.
Less people sell it than we used to know.
No. Not really. It's changed a lot. We've went from like Nas to like Tyler the Creator.
Oh, you're talking
about how much different their styles are.
I mean, I'm buying. I don't mean selling.
So wait, what?
I should probably cut that out.
No, you'll be fine. But no, it has changed a lot. If you're not paying attention, then that's your problem. But it has changed because if you look at when I was like 10 years ago, when I was growing up as this, whatever, 17, 16 year old, listening to hip hop. I was listening to, like, what was the most popular act out right at the time? Like, DMX, Nas, like...
Black Rob, like, Jada whoa.
Kiss, Black Rob, sure.
Whoa!
Yeah, but it was the most popular, if you think about it right now, who's, like, popping off? It's, like, Lil Wayne, Tyler, the Creator.
I still think the dominant name right now is probably Eminem. He's still better than...
Yeah, Eminem's... yo, bro, Eminem's like, whoa.
He's his last good. Album
but in 90s terms.
With Royce the 5'9 was tight. I gotta give him props.
I still listen to a lot of 50, and 50's got a lot of stuff, and 50 is extremely good.
I feel like he likes it better though.
He likes to slap people around for no reason.
Yeah, he does like to slap people around. That's mad funny. I read about that. Yeah, but I don't know, man. Look at his camp though. I like Lloyd Banks is better. He has a tighter flow than 50 any day.
He can't freestyle for shit though.
What's his name? Tony Yayo is good at freestyling, and Tony Yayo is good, more brolic than 50. He brings it pretty hard. And Young Buck is a really good rapper.
I've always liked Buck more than
so. Out of his camp, you can actually say that 50 Cent is the worst actual rapper. He might be the best businessman, but he's the worst actual lyrically gifted out of everybody. Because I'll give Lloyd Banks and Young Buck way more like lyrical prowess than 50 Cent. I don't know about you.
I don't know. When you listen to some of the music he's made, man, oh boy.
His first album was fire. I'll give him that. But he's gotten some like really weak joints, especially on Massacre and shit. There's a lot of like duds.
Name one place where you don't, where you can't apply prowess.
I don't know.
How many times has he been number one?
A children's playground.
Yeah. Okay.
I stayed up all night writing that joke.
Jay-Z's still...
Yeah, but he's not rapping anymore.
You know,
as
he's
much
rapping
as he
about his daughter now.
I don't know, bro. Well, Jay-Z's best album was his first one. And it got worse, got better.
You were feeling it?
I was feeling reasonable doubt. It.
What are you two, like the Cisco and fucking Ibra to rap game?
Yeah, actually. We're like way younger and more handsomer. It got better, like... game than them. Cisco and Ebert are herbs, bro. Do not compare me to Cisco.
What the or fuck
Ebert.
Are you on about?
What do you mean, bro? I'm just defending my name against you, Cisco accusing ass. What the fuck's wrong with you?
I don't listen to Cisco.
Cisco.
That's something that show up on your playlist.
Dong, 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 dong.
Yeah.
That's our version.
Yeah, I'm sure they remixed that
on your playlist. Don't even lie.
No, it ain't, yo. I can show you. Come here, bro. No Cisco in my system. The only Cisco I got is some upstairs in the kitchen, bro. That's canola oil, bro. I got no Cisco. I got Cisco the Kid by Sublime, and I have Cisco, the Cisco Kid by War. So I don't have any actual Cisco. I only have songs with the word Cisco in them. Speaking of this, you throw me off track,
like a
bro.
Router and shit?
You throw me off track here, bro.
That's my whole, that's the whole reason I'm here.
You throw me off track. We're going to get some hip-hop conversation, like, back in the day. You know what I mean? Why
back
not?
Back in the day.
It was.
I think this topic's been killed to death.
No, it hasn't. We mentioned like three things, bro. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me?
This topic. Like the Source and High Times mixed together right now.
Yeah, bro. That's true. That's actually a really good comparison. We're like the Source and High Times mixed together.
That's actually pretty cool.
When we talk about hip-hop, throw some weed in there. Why not? Those go hand in hand. One of my favorite websites growing up was a website called weedcarriers.com. Because if you notice, every rapper in the game has a posse to carry his weed for him. Think about it. That's why he has like so many like entourage members. That's really the reason that every rapper walks around with like 13 people.
Except for Nas. He just walks around with, like, fucking, like, some DJ from, like, the Lower East Side, and that's it.
Keeping it real.
And it does. I've seen Nas live a few times. He never brings, like, I've seen Papoose live. I've seen, like, Carmega live. There's always, like, 14 people on stage. You can't even make out who's who. It's like, yeah, I know you guys are, like, your friends with him, but, you know, let me see him in the crowd. You know, I've been to a lot of concerts, and most hip-hop concerts, is always an entourage on stage. Nas brings it real. The only time he had anybody else on stage was when he performed with Damian Marley, which was a couple years ago.
In which case, he had awesome just him show. On stage also.
Well, yeah, but they did. It was weird. The way they did their whole concert was, it was Nas did a full set by himself. They did a set together, and then Damian Marley came out and did a full set by himself. It was like a 3-hour show, like 3.5-hour show. They each got over an hour, like together and each solo. So that was really like an insane like show. But yeah, so that's what I'm saying. Nas is like one of the few rappers that like I respect for him because his voice, like he says, one mic, it's all he needs. He doesn't need 14 people with him on stage. Papoose literally was like the shortest guy on stage. You couldn't even see him. It was just like mad like dudes, and like all you see is like Papoose in the middle kind of bobbing around. Like you can't even see if he's in there. So like I'm not calling out Papoose, but he's not the king of New York. He's pretty irrelevant. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Like, even, like, when I saw Ludacris, so, like, he was at, like, a small show, like, promotion, like, for, like, AT&T or some shit. He still had, like, 4 people on stage with him. Like, at a small venue, like, for, like, 100, like, maybe 300 people.
So what'd you think? It must have been Ludacris.
It was pretty, like, you know, it wasn't mystical, that's for sure, but it wasn't fabulous either. It was pretty, so I'm telling you.
So basically, G90's opinions don't necessarily reflect my opinions, so if you want to kidnap and kill him for what he said, that's fine, but I had nothing to do with it.
That'll make me famous, bro, please, kidnap me, but don't kill me. You can kidnap me.
But make sure you rape me before you kill me. I know you
will grow to like
me.
If you kidnap me, you will have Stockholm Syndrome because you will grow to like your hostage.
What is Stockholm Syndrome? Do you even know what that is?
Yeah, it's when it's a hostage becomes like compassionate towards his kidnapper because he understands where he's coming from, kind of. Anyone's trying
to help
him.
Like the battered wife syndrome?
Kind of, yeah.
He watches too many movies, man.
So, that's a pretty common term. You don't read enough books.
Are you kidding me?
Read a lot of magazines, though. All
right, fine.
You look at the pictures. You skim through the articles. Don't lie.
Oh, we got photo evidence of this. Anyway,
that's what everybody does.
Let's
magazines
take a quick
aren't
break.
For reading.
Do you want to take a quick break? Regroup.
Yeah, let's take
come
a quick
back.
Break and regroup, and we'll be right back.
Magazines are for reading. Come on.
Well, you could read them during the break. We'll be right back after this.
Used to be the goofy man you hounded, the special ed kid at lunchtime the bitches wouldn't stand around with. I would jack off so much back at my parents' house, and now my dick has a permanent imprint of my hand around it. Life was lame, I had to pay money to fuck a whore. I couldn't pull a damn anorexic bitch in a tug of war. But then I made enough money for me to fund a tour. Now the ladies show me the goodies under they wonder bra. I'm going door to door with foreign swords causing more than war. Slaying rappers commercial or horrorcore. So hold your head cause I'ma torture yours, leaving morbid sores. I promise you it'll be hard to ignore the gore. Hip hop's dead and I'm the lucky savior. I'm kinda mad and I don't wanna pile up the anger. All these no flow gimmicky ass fired up behaviors with whack beats and gap teeth like Tyler the Creator. Motherfucker, you not dope. So you try to get some attention by cussing and eating a fucking cockroach? And gobbling? You get no props on it. It sucks so much I get blowjobs from it. I been told you niggas I'm real. If you whack and no one's confronted you on your bullshit, then I will. Hate on me, but you can't deny skill. I crush all the momentum that you guys build with my eyes sealed. You faggots got me cussing. And only reason you probably buzzing is cause you slave as an Illuminati puppet. Y'all really are one. Beat it, you're gone done. You think real niggas feeling your shit? Come on, son.
I'm the illest and it's faux shizzle. My flow sizzles, your boy hot, go hard like some cold nipples. You niggas are making it so simple. My swag makes the ladies wave like fat stomachs with bold ripples. I know you niggas wish you could prevent it, cause I get bucked like my Kool-Aid got way too much sugar in it. You better run like I'm booger flicking. Homie, I've been good at rapping, now I'm trying to get gooder with it. So I'ma just go beast and bring that West Coast heat, cause I'll be damned if you flex on me. The radio is filled with garbage over techno beats, and all these songs about cash and what we just don't need. Yo, nobody care about how much money you stack. I murder everything I touch, buddy, move back. Got enough guts to soon trash and bust up your fluke act and leave your fans saying, how the fuck does he do that? My ranking is vicious, you thinking it isn't? Come pay me a visit if you feel that you may be offended. Baby, I'm wicked, crazy and sickening with the face of a nimwit. I be calling out names, but I ain't taking attendance. Some bitch was like, have you got me crying? Cause you said I could call you while you out on tour. Shit, and I be trying. I even text you, but you not replying. So when your new shit finally dropped, that's one album I will not be buying. With you to Hollywood, and you don't even have 2 minutes. Ever since you got your buzz, you don't know how bad you tripping. You went to that host house last night, and you said that you didn't. I seen the pic on Facebook, the skank bitch done tagged you in it. I got put on with the beast, they flow, not a slut. They want a bone when they see me, whoa, so I must. I take them home, let the wee-wee grow. Then I bust from different strokes like the TV show. See, when I be coming through kicking it raw, niggas like, gee, he's dope. If there's anyone throwing dirt in my name, then you know he'd be toast. For all of you rappers who bringing me drama, homie, please be ghost. The only reason I'm being aggressive is cause we need hope.
Hey, yo, Hop, tonight fucking love you, cause you supplied the best rhymes. Since your flow is kinda strange, you should sign with Tech9. You design direct lines, who am I to just lie? Every single night I play your music right at bedtime. And usually I'm not in a dark dick. I wanna do something freaky enough to win your heart with.
I said, what you wanna do? She said, it's simple, Marcus. I wanna blow it before you put it in like a Nintendo cartridge. Bitch, I'm hotter than a UV ray. Hotter than the thought of Nicki Minaj naked making a booty shake. Hot enough to pull up to your show and steal your groupie date. Hot enough to melt the ice cream that's on Gucci's face. And now you having hot flashes. All the shit that you ever wanted in one MC, Hop has it. Don't rap if you do not practice. I cock block whack shit, now get ready for knock madness.
DJ G90, Alexx. This is W.E.E.D. 420 AM.
We're now in a cave, not in the building anymore.
Yes, DJ G90 live in the cave, the man cave, to be exact. So that
live
was a fun show.
Pre-recorded.
I do have to say that was a fun show.
Yes, good times. Definitely a fun show. Our dear friend Ilya coming over here.
MC.ILLZ in the building. Frankie Graham. I think
Graham's.
We had a very solid production. And to be honest with you, I couldn't be happier. Going over the election results, because it is Stupor Tuesday. We give the victory of the night.
I definitely got Stupor today.
Yeah.
Like I've said of many shows.
That's why I say it's called Stupor Tuesday.
Because
by the end, you're definitely stupering.
We've definitely more than lived up to our name.
Yes.
And I've said this many times, and I think it's very true.
420 AM W.E.E.D. I think that deserves a rip.
We fuck our livers while you're fucking laughing. Radio 420 AM W.E.E.D. Yeah, buddy.
All right.
Smoking that pot. All right, gee.
That was good. That was good stuff, folks.
That was definitely good stuff.
I have a big announcement.
A huge announcement.
Right now. No one's heard this, including you.
That arm extent was almost full length. There must be
almost.
A huge announcement.
Huge, huge.
Yes.
Dimensional, many dimensions of an announcement.
You
it's
paint
coming.
The picture before you even say it.
Our next show is going to be a big one.
The 10th episode?
It's going to be the 9th episode.
Why is that the big one?
Because
we're doing it ass backwards.
We have a very special guest coming in. Studio. This coming weekend.
Who's that?
I'm not at liberty to disclose his name.
What the fuck you mean you're not at liberty to disclose?
But it's gonna
all
be
fair.
Big. No, on air. He's a member of the Occupy Wall Street movement who was recently arrested, and he's gonna discuss that with us. So
I'm gonna smoke some pot with a dirty hippie.
Not really. I mean, I know him for
not
he's
really
not really a dirty
or
hippie.
No.
He's not really, he's not really a hippie. He feels the system's unfair. You can't be generalizing things like that. We're a very non-biased group. Once you meet him, you'll see that there are.
No, you're a very non-biased group. I just crack jokes whenever possible.
Yes, but that still doesn't mean but you're equally biased against everybody. So you're non-biased.
Including my own kind. So
exactly.
I just like to make jokes.
Exactly.
Why can't I be left alone to make jokes?
You are. recycle this.
Yeah, before some seagulls get stuck in it with that six-pack plastic.
Yeah. Dude, I'm telling you, you can make jokes, but, you know, spread the hate around. That's what I say. And spread the love around. Either
Your
way.
Favorite drink is Haterade?
Yeah. It's going to be a really big show. Occupy Wall Street will be represented. It's going to be Grassroots 420. We're calling the show Grassroots 420 because, you know, every week we bring you
I'm
the
not
Grassroots.
Broadcasting live from Zuccotti Park.
You're
bro.
Not. He's coming here.
Okay.
He's good peoples. We'll call him Hush Puppy for now. And we'll get more details next week.
He's not going to wear slippers, is he?
No. Okay. No, not at all. But I can show you a picture of him.
I'm still doing the stereotyping thing, aren't
I? I can show you a picture of him. And maybe if I show you a picture of him, you might take it a little more seriously. Is it possible? I think it is possible.
Why? He looks like a serious activist.
I think so. How about I'll just show you. You judge for yourself. You don't know this person, obviously, which is...
So you're what do I have to believe?
You don't have to believe anything.
Well, then what am I judging this picture based on?
Based on the content of the picture. Because a picture tells 1,000 words. Well, whatever. It doesn't matter. But this is a good one right here. Yeah?
He's into computers?
Very anonymous.
Is he into computers?
A little bit. Not like.
Oh, well, then he's just posing.
Well, not really.
Really. I mean, how are you going to put on
V for Vendetta didn't have computers. That was where the mask was originally from.
Yes, but since V Vendetta is a very old movie, and now Anonymous have taken over that whole thing.
I know, but old is the relative. It's not that old. It's 2006.
I can still use it as a Halloween costume for 3 or 4 years. Well, right? That's the mentality you're going on.
I'm sorry?
You repeat better that. Be.
Last part, I didn't hear it.
I said you better be.
No, before that.
before that, who cares? Radio 420AM W.E.E.D.
Yes,
the next
week,
topic is just as good as the last one.
Who next week's going to be big, okay? No matter what you say, it's going to be a fun show.
I'll try to beat my own drinking record for the show.
Oh, I hope so. That will be fun. That would be fun.
That's a reoccurring theme.
We actually have some pictures from tonight's broadcast, which we might put on the Facebook.
Broadcast?
You can see the debauchery in person.
The
yeah.
Broadcast.
The broadcast, yeah.
It's like Broadway, the South Park episode, but it's the broadcast.
Yes, that was a good episode.
We're definitely broadcasting now, bro.
we're podcasting. Pod blasting on our podcast.
Getting blasted while we cast it.
Exactly.
All right.
So next week, we're going to have a member of Occupy Wall Street here. It's going to be a fun show. We're going to talk a lot about politics.
Giggity goo, your mom here.
A lot of social issues will be discussed. And I'm sure we'll have a good time again.
I dropped out of junior high specifically not to hear about social studies issues.
Yeah, dude. Well, welcome to my world. You're going to get edumatated right now. I'll tell you what. So don't worry about that. Don't worry about that.
I didn't go to fake medical school to be called Mr.
You did not. This is true. But that's what's happening this coming weekend. And I'm really excited about that. Otherwise, good show. Again, always show good entertainment and such. Can't speak less of it.
As they say down south, airtime.
We're going to have some tracks coming up as well. And then we'll see you guys this weekend with a very exclusive show. We're going to have to do Grassroots 420, discuss some issues. Alexx might pass out from boredom.
Yeah. No, I'm not going to pass out from boredom, guys. No. We'll see you next week. Sorry for not participating in the conversation as much as you probably hoped I wouldn't. In which case, you should be pretty grateful. We'll see you guys next week. Radio 420 AM, W-E-E-D. That number again is 347-67, 420 AM. And we'll see you guys next week.
One. Yo, yo, yo. This is
yo.
This is a special public service announcement from WEED 420 AM. Your host, DJ G90.
I didn't know you did any public service.
This is going to be public.
Aside from the mandated stuff.
And corporate. What I wanted to do with this PSA is to announce...
Public and corporate.
It's a corporate service announcement, too, because some of these are
Jesus,
corporations.
What are you, Facebook?
No, I'm not. Not yet. But I'm on it.
What do you have to say?
All right. So... I'd like to announce, officially...
Why do we have to bring back the show after we just told them goodbye?
Don't tell them that. This is a different
segment. Well, no, I'm not telling them that.
Because I'm trying to make an announcement.
I'm reminding them of that.
I'm trying to make an announcement. I keep being interrupted.
All right, and here we go. And the announcement is, let's see if it lives up to bringing the show back after we said goodbye.
It will.
Rush Limbaugh. All the advertisers that dropped Rush Limbaugh's show this week, and there were several
of them. Yes, his name ends with GH.
I'd like to make a formal announcement saying, I want to welcome these advertisers to take those advertising dollars, put them towards our show. We are a little more, down to earth than Mr. Rush Limbaugh, but I feel like we love women here, so at least we're not going to be
caught. Yeah, we definitely love
caught.
Women, but
we're not
going
to be caught with these disparaging comments, so we'd like to welcome the advertisers.
We don't need no disparaging comments. First off, this show is destined for greatness. Well, all we do is positive things. We just try to make people smile, and that's how the show gets by, man.
Exactly. And you know what? Rush Limbaugh doesn't know what he's talking about. He called this girl, Sandra Fluke, who was a Georgetown Law student, a slut.
You know what I call her?
And a prostitute. But you don't know Georgetown Law students. You got to take them on 3 dates minimum. Come on, give me a break here.
She's just a fucking... just a girl, bro.
Yeah, and Rush Limbaugh, I just want to call him out on his hypocrisy. He's full of shit. Number one...
People are people.
Number one, first of all, they found him prescriptions of Viagra, which is covered by his health insurance. So contraception should definitely be covered by health insurance.
Your tax money's helping him get it all.
Exactly. And that just creeps me out.
It does creep me out too, bro.
I do not want my tax dollars going towards... Shit.
Why can't some of the tax dollars go to me getting laid?
Yeah, exactly. He is ridiculous.
That's bullshit.
And then he said... that he'd like to, you know, like, I mean, give me a break. You know, he's complaining about, like, the tax dollars aren't paying for Georgetown private. It's a private school, number one, Georgetown.
Yeah, break him off a piece of that Kit Kat bar.
Your taxes aren't paying for a private school's health insurance. Georgetown pays for its own health insurance if a student chooses.
So
and then it charges
really
the student.
Private school, ain't it?
It is. And it's completely even making this all more ridiculous. And the fact that she goes to Georgetown as a law student, she's not a slut.
What about the latest accusations that we received in our inbox that you were a Mormon?
I?
Yeah.
The conspiracy grows further?
I think so.
They're taking over? Am I infiltrating? Have I been infiltrated?
I've actually...
Has my identity been compromised?
Well, I've received an email that said one of your friends is a very profoundly, deeply religious Mormon. And
are you kidding me?
He would like you to see this video.
Which email?
I don't know. It came to my inbox.
Your inbox? Your personal inbox?
I think the Church of Latter-day Saints is spamming.
Oh, my God. It's deeper. I was in their database.
And they used your name on your behalf.
They used I'm in their database somehow. I did not officially authorize my name being in their database.
Yeah, but how do they know I'm friends with you?
I don't know, bro.
That's pretty.
You think they put a
weird
tracking device on me when I was there back in August of 2010? Because I have.
No, but I'm not about to put a finger up your butthole to find out.
Why would you automatically think that's where they would put the tracking device?
Why wouldn't they?
It was behind my ear.
Why wouldn't they?
What is this?
Exactly. That's why they wouldn't put it behind your ear. Because it's what it is. How often do you pick your butthole in public? Not as often as you do your ear.
I usually do it in private if I do it at all. Not in public.
Yeah, that's a good setting to do it in. But still, if you had to do it in public.
So, getting back, kind of off track there, buddy. Any advertisers?
Yes, that's right. Joe Flacco. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, Rush
he's not going to receive any notoriety on this show.
He's a fat blowhard. The new rising revolution is W.E.E.D. 420 a.m. Any advertisers?
Bro, I just want to suffocate him with his own upper lip.
I really do, bro. With his neck folds. Just this fat bastard asshole.
How can you say that? That's so messed up.
Exactly. I can't understand how a woman could be Republican at this point. It boggles my mind. She's voting against her own sexual interest.
The Republican Party. A vote for us is a vote against the vagina.
It really is. This is the unhippest place of all time. Yeah.
Yeah, well, the Republican primary is definitely a sausage fest this year.
Yeah, well, obviously, but listen, it's not like their women are any better. They're just as scary or brainwashed.
Ladies' night was 4 years ago. Obama won that.
All right. Well, on that note, let's say we'll see you next week. We'll see you this week, coming up a few more days, W.E.E.D., 420 a.m.
We'll see you this weekend.
Yes.
Oh, here we go, party, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's do this.
Let's say.
Okay. Radio 420 a.m., call us up, leave us a message about any of the topics you heard on the show today or something you'd like to bring up. 347-674-20AM. The number again is 1-347-674-2026. All right, buddy. All right, and we're out.
DJG90 has left the building.
And Alexx is leaving it too. La, 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 la. That's me falling on my face, walking down the stairs. We'll be right back next week after I get my nose fixed.